Now we will discuss about the transfer phenomena. We have applied the kinetic theory of gases when the gas is in equilibrium state. But if the gas is not in equilibrium state, we have the following three cases. First one, the components of velocity U, V and W may not have same value in all parts of the gas. This will result in relative motion of the gas layers with respect to one another. Now the layers moving faster impart or transport momentum to the slower moving layers to bring the equilibrium state. This gives rise to the phenomenon of viscosity. Second one, the different parts of the gas may be at different temperatures. Now, to bring the equilibrium state, the molecules of the gas will transport kinetic energy from regions of higher temperature to regions of lower temperature. This gives rise to the phenomenon of conduction. Third point, the different parts of the gas may have different densities. That is, number of molecules per unit volume. Now, to bring the equilibrium state, the molecules of the gas transport mass from regions of higher density to regions of lower density. This gives rise to the phenomenon of diffusion. From above discussion, it is clear that the transport of momentum, energy and mass represent viscosity, conduction and diffusion. These are called transport phenomena. Next is viscosity of gases. Here we will discuss the phenomenon of viscosity on the basis of mean free path. Let a gas flow over a horizontal surface Ox with a velocity small as compared to the thermal velocity of the molecules in the direction of Ox. Then the velocity of layer in contact with the surface is zero and it gradually increases as we move up from O in y direction at a uniform rate du by dy. Consider a layer AB at a certain distance from Ox. Let U be the velocity with which the gas flows in this layer. Further, consider two layers CD and EF above and below AB respectively at a distance lambda. The layer above AB exerts a tangential force on the layer below AB, tending to accelerate it in the forward direction. On the other hand, the layer below AB exerts an equal force on the layer above AB, tending to retard it in the backward direction. In this way, there is a difference in velocities on the two sides of AB. This sets up a tangential force between the layers which opposes the motion of the gas. This force is called a viscous force and the property is called as viscosity. The coefficient of viscosity eta of a fluid is defined as the tangential force per unit area per unit velocity gradient between the layers of the fluid. That is, capital F equals to eta into du by dy. That is, eta equals to F divided by du by dy. Now, explanation of this kinetic theory. The molecules of the gas above AB have a greater velocity of flow and hence possesses a greater average momentum in the direction of flow than those below it. Now, due to thermal agitation, some of the molecules above AB will move downwards while some molecules below AB having smaller average momentum will be moving upwards. As there is no mass motion in y direction due to advancement of the gas, the number of molecules moving downwards must be equal to the number of molecules moving upwards. In this way, the slower stream of gas below AB gains momentum while the faster stream above AB loses momentum. According to Newton's laws of motion, the gain in momentum means a force in the forward direction
while the loss in momentum means a force in backward direction. Therefore, the layer above AB experiences a retarding force in the backward direction, while the layer below AB experiences an accelerating force in the forward direction. This accounts for the viscosity. So, the viscosity may be considered to be the phenomenon of transport of momentum. Now, expression for viscosity. Let n be the number of molecules per unit volume of the gas and c be their average velocity. Due to thermal agitation with which they are moving in all directions, we consider the molecules crossing unit area of the plane AB from the two planes CD and EF situated at a distance lambda. It should be remembered that on arriving at AB, the molecules will have their first collisions, that is, first transfer of momentum. Suppose that 1/3 of the molecules are moving in each of three directions parallel to the three coordinate axes, there will be equal number of molecules traveling in the upward and downward directions. So, n by 6 molecules are moving upward and equal number of molecules downward. Since c is the average velocity of the molecules and hence the number crossing unit area per second either will be given by nc by 6. Taking m to be the mass of the molecule, the total mass crossing unit area of AB per second either side is nmnc by 6. The velocity of the gas in layer CD equals to u plus lambda into du by dy. The velocity of the gas in layer EF equals to u minus lambda du by dy, where u is the velocity flow of gas along AB and du by dy is the velocity gradient in the direction from CD to EF. The momentum carried for downward by the molecules crossing unit area of AB per second from the plane CD is given by P1 equals to mass into velocity. P1 equals to 1 by 6 mnc into u plus lambda du by dy. Similarly, momentum carried upwards P2 equals to 1 by 6 mnc into u minus lambda du by dy. Net momentum transferred for second downwards P1 minus P2 equals to 1 by 3 mnc lambda into du by dy. Under steady state conditions of flow of the gas, the transfer of momentum per unit area per second is equal to the tangential viscous force between the layers. Therefore, capital F equals to 1 by 3 mnc lambda into du by dy. Now, the coefficient of viscosity, eta, is defined as the ratio of the tangential force to the velocity gradient. Therefore, eta equals to 1 by 3 mnc into lambda, that is mnc rho c lambda, where mn equals to rho density of the gas. At constant temperature, rho increases with pressure and lambda decreases in the same ratio. Therefore, eta is independent of pressure. Substituting the values of lambda equals to 1 by root 2 pi n d square, we get eta equals to mnc divided by 3 root 2 pi d square. Conclusions. From this expression, we may conclude that the coefficient of viscosity of a gas is independent of pressure or density, as the expression is free of n. The coefficient of viscosity of a gas is directly proportional to the average molecular velocity c. This is directly proportional to the square root of the absolute temperature of the gas, since C is directly proportional to root T. The coefficient of viscosity is inversely proportional to the square of the diameter of the molecule. The coefficient of viscosity of a gas is directly proportional to the mass of the molecule of the gas. Next is thermal conductivity. The transport of heat energy from one region of the gas that is at higher temperature to the region of lower temperature gives rise to the transport phenomenon of thermal conduction. The phenomenon of thermal conductivity of gases may be explained on the basis of kinetic theory of gases like viscosity. In this case, the molecules of the gas are considered as carriers of heat energy. Imagine the gas to be at rest and divided into several layers. The molecules of one layer differ from those of other layers in respect of temperature. Thus, there exists a uniform temperature gradient dT by dy in the gas. Let the layer represented by OX be the coldest and the temperature gradually increases in OY direction. Consider a layer AB at a distance y from OX which is at a temperature T. There are two layers CD and EF on either side of AB at a distance lambda, whose temperatures are T plus lambda dT by dy and T minus lambda dT by dy. The phenomenon of thermal conduction is due to the transport of energy. The molecules of the gas above plane AB on an average are at high temperature than the molecules of the gas below AB. Hence, the molecules of the gas coming from CD and passing downwards across AB will possess more kinetic energy as the temperature is more than the molecules coming from EF and passing across AB in the upward direction. In this way, the energy of molecules below AB is continuously increasing while that of molecules above AB is continuously decreasing. This is the process by which heat is conducted through the gas until unit the gas attains the thermal equilibrium. For this expression, the molecules of the gas are moving in all directions due to thermal agitation. We can imagine that 1/3 of molecules are moving in each of the three directions parallel to x, y, and z axis. Now the number of molecules crossing the layer AB in one direction per unit area per second can be written as NC by 6, where N is the number of molecules per unit volume of the gas and C the average velocity of molecules. If M be the mass of the molecules, the total mass crossing unit area of AB per second either side is given by MNC by 6. The total heat energy Q1 carried by all the molecules in crossing layer AB downwards per unit area per second is given by Q1 equals to mass into specific heat into temperature, that is MNC by 6 into CV into T plus lambda dT by dy. Similarly, the total heat energy Q2 carried by all molecules in crossing the layer AB upwards per unit area per second is given by Q2 equals to MNC by 6 CV T minus lambda dT by dy. Therefore, now transfer of energy Q equals to Q1 minus Q2. Therefore, Q equals to 1 by 3 MNC CV lambda dT by dy. The coefficient of thermal conductivity of gas is defined as the quantity of heat that flows per unit area per second per unit temperature gradient and is given by Q equals to K into dT by dy, or K equals to Q divided by dT by dy. Substituting the value of Q, we get K equals to 1 by 3 MNC CV lambda dT by dy divided by dT by dy. Therefore, K equals to 1 by 3 rho C CV lambda, where rho is the density of the gas. We know that lambda equals to 1 by under root pi d square n. On substituting that, we get K equals to 1 by 3 root 2 MCCV by pi d square, which is the required expression for coefficient of thermal conductivity of a gas. Conclusions for this is the expression is free from N. So, for a given temperature, that coefficient of thermal conductivity of a gas is independent of pressure. The expression shows that coefficient of thermal conductivity of a gas is proportional to average molecular speed C, that is proportional to the square root of Kelvin temperature of gas. The relation between the thermal conductivity and viscosity is expressed as coefficient of viscosity eta equals to 1 by 3 mnc lambda, and coefficient of thermal conductivity k equals to 1 by 3 mnc cv lambda. Therefore, k by eta equals to cv. We know that M equals to capital M by capital N, where capital M is molecular weight and N is Avogadro's number. Substituting that, we get K equals to 1 by 3 root 2 C by pi d square into M by N Cv. We know that C equals to under root 8 pi kT by pi M, where K is Boltzmann constant. Substituting, we get K equals to 1 by 3 root 2 into Cv by pi d square into M by N into under root 8 kT by pi M. Thus, we find the coefficient of thermal conductivity is inversely proportional to the square root of mass of molecule of the gas. Next is diffusion of gases. Consider the case of two gases, say H2 and N2, at the same temperature and pressure. Let the two gases are brought in a vessel in such a way that the lighter gas H2 is in upper part and heavier gas N2 is in lower part. It is observed that the heavier molecules of N2 move up, the lighter molecules of H2 move down till the gases become thoroughly mixed. This phenomenon is called as diffusion. The diffusion is the process by which the mass gets transferred inside a gas from a region of higher concentration to the region of lower concentration. Further, the diffusion coefficient D of a gas is defined as the number of molecules of the gas crossing per unit surface area per second per unit concentration gradient. The phenomenon can be explained on the basis of kinetic theory of gases by considering the transport of mass across the given plane. Expression for the diffusion. Consider that a mass of the gas is moving between parallel planes AB and CD. Let the concentration increases in vertical direction as we go from AB to CD through the intermediate plane XY. Thus, the concentration of the gas above XY is greater than that below XY. In order to bring the equilibrium, the molecules of the gas will cross the plane XY from AB to CD and vice versa. The phenomenon is known as diffusion. The diffusion of gas molecules through the intermediate plane can be considered as the transport of the mass. Let N equals to concentration of gas molecules of plane XY, dN by dZ equals to concentration gradient, then concentration of plane CD equals to N plus lambda into dN by dZ, where lambda equals to distance between planes XY and CD. Here, lambda denotes the mean free path. Similarly, concentration at plane AB equals to N minus lambda dN by dZ. As the molecules are moving in all possible directions due to thermal agitation, we can take 1/3 of the total number of move along any axis, or 1/6 of molecules along any axis in one particular direction. The number of molecules crossing plane XY downwards per unit area per second will be 1/6 C into N plus lambda into dN by dZ, and those up upward will be 1 by 6 into C into n minus z, n minus lambda into dn by dz. The net number crossing unit area per second of plane xy in downward direction is 1 by 3 C lambda into dn by dz. Now the coefficient d is given by d equals to number of molecules crossing unit area per second divided by concentration gradient. That is, by substituting that we get 1 by 3 C lambda. Now d equals to 1 by 3 C lambda rho by rho, that is eta by rho, where eta equals to 1 by 3 rho C lambda, that is coefficient of viscosity. Therefore d equals to eta by rho. For lambda is directly proportional to 1 by n, which is also proportional to T by P. Therefore d is directly proportional. D is directly proportional to 1 T power 3 by 2 into P power minus 1. Thus, the coefficient of diffusion is directly proportional to T power 3 by 2, where T is the absolute temperature and is inversely proportional to pressure P.